Evangelist Gabriel Fernandes, and God has called and commissioned me to lead people of all walks of life to a deep and genuine encounter with Him. By the grace of God, I have seen many people touched by God in this ministry, and I encourage you, my dear friend, to connect in faith. Believe and you shall receive in the name of Jesus. Spirit, you are welcome in this place. Holy Spirit, you are welcome in this place. Omnipotent Father of mercy and grace, you are welcome in this place. Holy Spirit, you are welcome in the place where my dear friend is watching. Come and touch my dear friend and change my dear friend's life for the glory of King Jesus. Holy Spirit, you are welcome in this place. Holy Spirit, you are welcome in this place. Omnipotent Father of mercy and grace, you are welcome in this place. Lord Holy Spirit, take over control of this place where I'm recording and take over control of the place where my dear friend is watching. I pray this in the name of Jesus. Hello, hello, hello to you, my dear friend. Welcome to another video proudly brought to you by GFM United Prayer and Revival Ministry, the ministry that aims to take you to a deeper place with God. I'm Evangelist Gabriel Fernandes, and I'm so happy to be with you today, my dear friend, on this wonderful, beautiful morning. It is another day that God has given us, and I am so happy and I'm rejoicing because God has given us another day to make our mark, another day to live to the fullest, another day to accomplish that destiny and that purpose that God has placed on your life. My dear friend, today I want to talk about the presence of God, and I want to pray for you that you will get a greater measure of the presence of God in your life, that you will get to know the presence of God, and that you will be able to live and walk in a constant presence lifestyle. But as usual, I like to start with a bit of a scripture foundation. And I want to read to you a few scriptures and show you some benefits of having the presence of God. I want to show you some keys and some benefits that will come about as you get deeper into the presence of God. And I know, like I know, that as we pray together today, my dear friend, you are going to be blessed beyond your expectation. God shall meet you at your point of need, and He shall give you the desire of your heart. Are you ready? Let us begin. The first key that I want to show you, my dear friend, comes from the book of Psalm chapter 16 verse 11, the ESV version. It says, "You make known to me the path of life. In your presence there is fullness of joy. At your right hand are pleasures forevermore." My dear friend, in the presence of God there is joy. In the presence of God, there is laughter, there is happiness. There is joy deep within you. If you are seeking deep inner joy, you need the presence of God. As you receive the presence of God, as we pray today, you will receive joy. The next scripture that I want to share with you comes from the book of Exodus, chapter 33, verse 14, the ESV version. And it says, "And he said, my presence will go with you, and I will give you rest." Another scripture from the book of Acts, chapter 3, verse 20 to 21, the ESV version, it says that times of refreshing may come from the presence of the Lord, and that He may send the Christ appointed for you, Jesus, whom heaven must receive until the time for restoring all things, about which God spoke by the mouth of His holy prophets long ago. The second thing that we can see, my dear friend, in the presence of God comes rest. Are you feeling tired in your soul, in your spirit? Are you feeling tired in your inner man? Is your inner man feeling burdened and weighed down? In the presence of God, you will receive rest. In the presence of God, you will also receive restoration. Have things been stolen from you? Have things been stolen from you? Has your strength been sapped? Has your energy been taken away? You will receive refreshing. This happens in the presence of God. And last but not least, from the book of Isaiah, chapter 64, verse 1 to 3, the ESV version, It says, "Oh, that you would rend the heavens and come down, that the mountains might quake at your presence, as when fire kindles brushwood, and the fire causes water to boil, to make your name known to the adversaries, that the nations might tremble at your presence. When you did awesome things that we did not look for, you came down and the mountains quaked at your presence." My dear friend, the first thing that I want to show you from this scripture is that the presence of God chases away the enemy. The enemy, the devil, demons, evil spirits, evil people, they quake at the presence. They can feel when someone has the presence, and they become very fearful because they know that the person who is carrying the presence has somebody greater in them than the one that they are carrying themselves. They become very afraid. Evil spirits are afraid when God's presence is around you. They see fire. They see the glory cloud around you. They see the presence of angels even around you when the presence of God is with you. Another thing that I want to share with you from this scripture is deliverance takes place in the presence, my dear friend. When you get into the presence of God, you will receive total deliverance. You might be watching this video and all you need to receive your miracle is the presence of God. Another thing that I want to show you, my dear friend, is that miracles happen in the presence. And that's the last thing that I'm going to show you. I want us to go into a time of prayer. Let us begin to seek God. As you receive the presence of God today, your life will be changed forevermore. You will go up, you will not come down. You will go up and you'll be blessed in the name of Jesus. In saying that, let's go into a time of prayer. Take your cell phone, your device, go somewhere private where you can seek God. And even as you go there, just begin to lift up some praises to God. Father, you are my Lord. You are my God. You are the God in whom we trust. We just worship you. We just praise you. We just lift you up, Lord. Thank you for this time that we can spend in your presence. Thank you so much, Lord, for your presence. We give you all the glory. We give you all the honor. We give you all the praise. Thank you, dear Jesus, for your presence. Thank you for the presence of the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father God Almighty. Thank you, Lord Jesus, that you made a way for us, that we could experience your presence, that we could experience you, that we could know you on a personal level. Thank you for all the things that you do for us. We just give you praise. We just give you praise. Lord, sometimes I look back at my own life and I see all the things that you've done for me. And I realize, who am I that God is mindful of me? I'm but a mere speck that you are mindful of me. And I'm so thankful and I'm so grateful for all that you do for me. I'm so thankful and I'm so grateful for all that you do for your child who's watching this video. Lord, we give you all the honor and all the praise. Be glorified today. Most of all, even in this recording right now, be glorified. May your name be lifted high. May your name be lifted high. May you receive all the glory and all the praise. We promise to give you all the glory, Lord. It is all yours. All the glory belongs to you, O Lord. Amen. Hallelujah. All the glory belongs to you. All the honor, all the praise belongs to you. Be glorified, O Lord. Be magnified, O Lord. Be lifted high in our lives, O Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. My dear friend, the presence and the power of God is here. But let's just take a moment. Say this with me. Say, Holy Spirit, I welcome you. Come and take over this atmosphere. Lord, Holy Spirit, take over this atmosphere where I'm recording. Take over the atmosphere where my dear friend is watching. Do something mighty for the glory of King Jesus. I pray this and I thank you for it, Lord. In your precious name, amen and amen. Hallelujah. My dear friend, the presence and the power of God is here. Now I want to pray for you. I want to pray with you and for you that God will touch you and change your life forever. Are you ready? Let us begin. As we go into a time of prayer, my dear friend, I want to encourage you to do three things. Number one, I want you to be in agreement with me. There is power in agreement. Comment in the comment section and agree with me. Comment and agree with me. Let us form a network of agreement all around the world. Number two, if you've got any private prayer request, you can send it in through my website, www.gabrielfernandesministries.org. Just go there and click on daily prayer list, fill in the form, fill in your requests and send it through. And it will come through to me. I'll trust God with you. You will receive your miracle. The third thing is, I'm sure you have a testimony. If you've got a testimony and you want to share, you want to give Jesus the glory, go to my website, www.gabrielfernandesministries.org. Click on testimony or testify. And even as you do that, fill in the form and click submit and it'll come through. But in saying that, let's go into a time of prayer. Our dear Heavenly Father, I stretch my hand towards this camera. Lord, I pray, let my dear friend watching this video experience your presence. Let my dear friend watching this right now, wherever my dear friend watching this is, distance is not a barrier. Distance is never a barrier for you. Let my dear friend watching this video receive your presence. Lord, I pray for my dear friend. Let my dear friend know your ways. Let my dear friend not just know your works or your miracles, but know your ways, know your presence, know you. Lord, I pray that my dear friend watching this video will receive the grace to experience a constant presence lifestyle. Lord, I pray that my dear friend watching this video, your son or your daughter, may experience the presence that's only available in Christ Jesus. Let them know your presence. Let them have the presence of the Holy Spirit around them. And Lord, as the presence comes around my dear friend watching this video, let my dear friend receive joy. Let my dear friend receive fullness of joy. Let my dear friend receive a miracle. Let my dear friend receive restoration, refreshing, and rest for their souls, for their spirit, for their inner man. I pray this in the name of Jesus. Lord, most of all, I pray for my dear friend. As they get to know your presence, let them know you. Let my dear friend, your son, my dear friend, your daughter, your dear child who's watching this video, let them know you as they receive your presence in their life. Lord, let your presence make an impact and a change. Let miracles happen in your presence. Let my dear friend watching this video know you and your presence. I pray this in the name of Jesus. And I thank you, Lord, for it. Amen. Hallelujah. My friend, the presence, the power of God is here so strongly. My heart is on fire. You know, by the grace of God, most of my life has been, if I can define it as miraculous. I've experienced the presence most of my life. I've experienced the anointing, the glory of God. I've had radical encounters with the Lord most of my life. And it started quite a while back. Even up to 10 years back when I got saved, when I got born again. In fact, it was 11 years back. I had a radical encounter with God. And it just happened over and over and over again. And even as this ministry began, I had an encounter with God. And that keeps on going. I've seen signs, wonders, and miracles. And why am I saying this, my dear friend? Because you can experience that too. God is available to you too. You are not disqualified. Maybe you made mistakes in the past. Maybe you messed up in the past. Maybe you did things that you're guilty or you feel sad about or you feel ashamed about. But I'm here to give you the good news. The good news is if you come to Jesus, He can give you the desires of your heart. He will take you back and He Himself, by His Spirit, will change you. He will change you. He will deliver you from those ways, from the things that you did in the past. He will set you free from the guilt and condemnation and the shame of the past, and you will be set free forevermore. You will know that there is a God, and you will experience this presence. But it starts with giving your life to Jesus. Won't you pray together with me if you haven't given your life to Jesus already? Pray together with me. Give your life to Jesus. Commit yourself to the Lord. Commit your life into His hands. The Bible says in the book of John, chapter 3, verse 16, "For God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in Him shall not perish, but have everlasting life." Whoever believes in Him shall not perish, but have everlasting life. The Bible also says in the book of Romans, chapter 10, verse 9, if you believe in your heart that Jesus Christ is Lord, and you also believe that God raised Him from the dead, meaning He's alive, and you confess it out loud that Jesus, You are my Lord and my Savior, you shall be born again. You shall have an experience with God. You shall have a radical encounter with God. It all starts with giving your life to Jesus. Let us do that together. Before we go on, before we do anything else, the Holy Spirit is tugging on my heart that I have to do this. Before we do anything else, let us first do that. Say this with me. Say, Jesus, I believe that You are Lord. I give my life to you. I give my life to you. I believe you came and died for me to restore me back to God again, to wipe away my sins, to make a way for me, to make a way where there seems to be no way. Come and save me, Lord Jesus. I believe you are alive right now. God raised you from the dead. Let me have an encounter with you, Lord Jesus. Change my life from the inside out by your Spirit. And baptize me with the Holy Spirit. Amen. My dear friend, I don't care if you had already given your life to Jesus before this, but something happened right now. Something happened, something miraculous. Your life will never be the same again. Now I want to speak a blessing over you. As you've received the presence of God, I decree and declare according to Job chapter 22 verse 28, which says, you shall decree a thing and it shall be established. I decree and declare you are blessed. You are blessed and you can never be cursed. I break all the curses that have been spoken over you in the name of Jesus. Now as you've received the presence, receive total deliverance in the name of Jesus. May your enemies quake and tremble. May they run for their lives in fear because you've got the presence of God on your life. May the devil, Satan, and all his cohorts, all his evil spirits and evil agents, may they tremble because you've got the presence of God on your life. May you receive total deliverance, total refreshing, total joy, joy deep within your spirit, deep within your inner man. Today, may you receive a recharge in your spirit, a boosting of the spirit man. May you know God. May you know his presence. May you know his word. May you know his power. In the name of Jesus, I bless you in the name of Jesus. May you come close to God and may God's grace keep you close to him. In the mighty name of Jesus, amen and amen. Hallelujah, my friend. God is amazing. He is wonderful. His presence is wonderful. May you be blessed today, even as you've watched this video. Until we meet again tomorrow for more powerful prayers that will bless and change your life. From myself, Evangelist Gabriel Fernandes, shalom and goodbye.
If you were blessed by this video and you'd like to give a seed, feel free to do so using any one of the secured links provided in the description. If you would like to partner with us to support the work of the gospel on a monthly basis, then you can do so via Patreon. The link for Patreon as well as other information is also provided in the description. Other than that, my friend, God bless you, God keep you, God make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. Until we meet again next time, shalom and goodbye.